Well, it's a question you've heard before, but thanks to a recent cover story in Atlantic Monthly magazine, we're asking it again today. Can women have it all, and does this question still need to be asked? Joining me now, Katie Pavlich, news editor for townhall.com, and pundit, writer, and activist Sally Kohn. Sally, I'm going to start with you. Can women have it all? What do you say?
I have to say, I do think it's a very provocative question, but it's increasingly outdated. And I especially think, frankly, in our economy, in our country today, nobody can have it all. I mean, part of the problem with our economy, part of the problem with America right now is it's broken. A very, very few number of people, small number of men and women, can have it all. And for the rest, we're all struggling for the crumbs, no matter what your gender.
Katie, what do you say?
I would say it depends on what having it all really means. I think for the past 40 years, women have been boxed into this idea that having it all doesn't necessarily mean actually having it all. It means having a big career and leaving your family behind. But the good news is that nowadays, there's a choice. You can stay at home with your family, or you can go out and have a career. Now, as Sally said, I think there's an issue with the way the American economy runs, the way that our lifestyles are now require two incomes. And not to mention, we're working really hard so the rest of the world and people in Europe can have vacation time.
Well, we are the most productive economy in the whole world. That's absolutely for sure. But you know what occurs to me, because you say this is a dated question. Why are we even asking this? Nobody ever asks, can men have it all? Why not?
They don't. That's right. And look, I actually disagree. I mean, the reality is women are forced to try and have it all right now, right? So we're forced to have jobs in our economy. Yes, productivity is up, but wages are going down. We need two income. Heck, most families could use three or four incomes if they could get it. Yeah. So you're exactly right. And the reality is, though, I actually do think more and more men are struggling with this as well. They're looking at the fact that, you know, we're working harder and harder for less and less money. They're trying to chip in at home, and they're trying to bring in the bucks. They're all struggling with the issues women have struggled with for generations.
Katie, when you look at this, when you peel it apart, you know, I mean, this is something that cropped up maybe 20 years ago, maybe 30 years ago we were talking about this issue. To me, it feels like old school, you know, like, the people who can have it all are the people who can afford a full-time nanny, or it's people who absolutely have to have both of those jobs, and they just have to make it work no matter what. At the end of the day, it really doesn't apply anymore, does it?
I think it does. I think there are pressures still for women to go out in the workplace and have a high-powered career. I think that's true. But in terms of the question about what you asked with men, I think maybe asking men whether they would like to maybe stay home with the kids while mom goes out and has this high-powered career would be a question, because for the past 40 years, men have been the ones responsible, in some cases, to go out and be the breadwinners while moms stay at home. Now, is that a problem? No, it's a personal choice. But in terms of having it all,
Katie, can I tell you how many men I know who say, please, please, go work. I'd love to stay at home.
I know.
Why did you keep me in the style? I've become accustomed.
But see, Jerry, you have a choice, and you have a choice to go out in the workplace, and it comes down to, I think, individuals. Do you want to go out and have a career, or do you want to maybe tie your budget into something where you're living on one income? It really just depends on how your family structure works and what works for you and where you want to spend your time. It doesn't come down to what these stereotypical norms are. We've broken through that a long time ago.
Sally.
Katie, I do got to disagree. I don't think we have any choices anymore. I mean, right now, look, a lot of men and women would love to stay home, and you're sort of implying, I think, this sort of dangerous feminist, oh, we've suggested that to be a good woman, you have to go out and have a successful career.
You know,
the point of feminism, every woman I've ever known from Gloria Steinem on down, was women should have the choice. So if women want to be able to have a successful career and have a family,
they should be able to have
the choice.
Is that... There's one way to do it. The problem with feminism is the same problem with sexism, that they have one kind of stereotype that they want you to be. Katie, do you agree?
I agree with you, Jerry. And speaking of women who have it all and who have done a lot with career and family, Gloria Steinem doesn't see Sarah Palin as an example of feminism when she's had both.
Right.
Gloria Steinem doesn't see Michelle Bachmann as someone who has been able to have it all, even though she's had, I believe it's 19 foster children and this highly successful career.
Great points, Katie.
Well, you know, I don't know, I can't put words in Gloria's mouth, but actually she has stood up for Sarah Palin and her career as examples of feminism. It's Sarah Palin who hasn't been grateful to feminism. Look, again, you're putting